My written report is there for you to see, and so I refer you to it. I will not restate all that's in there. I would like to give you a couple of impressions about your national leadership team. I'm rotating off after being on it for 3 years, which I think is a healthy way to run a session, quite frankly, and is a healthy way to run our national leadership team. When we rotate leadership, it means that no individual is there for term after term after term, and we're less open to anyone with a single agenda or hobby horse, and so it's a very healthy, effective team. When I came on, I didn't know much about the former, what it was, Committee on Administration, now the NLT. I'm just impressed at the level of leadership that exists in various corners of the EPC, and thank you for you churches and presbyteries sharing just incredible leaders who are on this team. I've learned from each and every one of them. The first impression at my first meeting, I just want you to know this about your national leadership team. We met at Central Presbyterian in St. Louis, the first meeting I attended, and the order of the day always on the first day of our meeting, and I just thought, okay, this is probably a throwaway, said that we were going to share and pray for one another in our denomination. We got to that point, and the order of the day, we shared with one another about what's going on in our personal lives and in our ministry for an hour. We then prayed for an hour for one another and our denomination, and I thought that was beautiful, and it makes a real spirit on the national leadership team. It's a relational community of spiritual leaders. It is not a board. So I want you to be aware of that, and that's through Jeff Jeremiah's leadership, as well as that's been handed down moderate chair to chair over these years. I want you to know a couple of other things that we hold in dear priority, and we say to each other at each meeting, likely, that the EPC, our aspiration is to follow through on what we defined back in, 2007 as what a missional denomination is. And part of that definition, that by the way, that kind of stuff did not exist. We were part of working with other denominations and thinkers, what is a missional denomination, and reimagining our denomination, and it states very clearly in that definition, which I believe is adopted by us, that a missional denomination exists to serve the ministry of its member churches and presbyteries. That it does not seek to create some national deal that everything is trying to feed. And so everything we do, we are attempting to resist being a top-down led denomination or affiliation of churches, but instead a national leadership and office that serves and resources and champions what the Holy Spirit of God is doing in our member churches and presbyteries. And we seek to do that at all times. I want to give you two examples of how that's happening right now that it just enthused me about the EPC, and they're both factual. One of them, we completed successfully the move of our national headquarters to Orlando. It's saving a lot of money for committee meetings, which is really good for presbyteries, churches, and the GA that pays for those. But I want you to note in my report that under the executive leadership, particularly of Phil Van Valkenburg and Jeff Jeremiah, we went from, for several years, having 20 full-time employees of the GA office to now down to 17 after the move, even though we've continued to grow as a denomination. And I just think that speaks to the priority of our executive leadership of being good stewards of all the funds that are entrusted through per member asking, so that as much of it as possible goes to advance our shared mission and vision together. I'm really proud of Jeff and Phil's leadership in that regard. The second statistic I'll share with you, and then I'm gonna close so I can be the answer to my own prayer about finishing by 5:30, is that, so one other just statistical example that I think is really great. In 2010, some of our vision initiatives were defined by the assembly under leadership of the then Committee on Administration. One of them has been church planting. And in 2010, when Jeff appointed a team under Tom Rick's leadership to say, we know we're called to grow in church planting, that's the propagation of the kingdom. We were a 2.1% church planting denomination. 2.1% of our member churches were church plants relative to the whole. If I can do that math, I think you probably get it too. That is an anemic church planting rate, is only half of what experts say is a healthy church planting denomination and was not okay. And we didn't think that was okay with the Lord. In the intervening years, that was 2.1%. As of last year, our church planting rate reached 4.3%, which is right in the heart of what experts say is a healthy church planting denomination. Congratulations, you're a healthy church planting denomination. But there's one more figure I'll give you. Just in 2017, in the churches that have been planted in the last 6 months, our church planting rate has grown from 4.3% to now 6.2% as of this week. So you are more than a healthy church planting denomination. You're an exemplary church planting denomination, and I think we should thank the Lord for that by His grace. And here's what I like most. Here's what I like most about that metric. Those are measurable results of our per member askings to resource church planting throughout the EPC. Not a single one of those churches was planted by the GA or the GA office. That came from culture change of us together saying, this is important, this is a priority, and culture change through leadership at the national level and the Presbyterian level, and then our ability to just resource and fan into flame what God is birthing in our churches and presbyteries. That's who planted every single church. That gives me great joy and great confidence about our future as the outgoing chair. And that's enough. You can read the rest of my report. I forget the official phrase. That's my report.